show admirable restraint, Bethany.
For a mage, you mean?
I could also say for a hawk, but yes, for a mage.
You have a sword. Why aren't you killing someone right now?
Fair point, but I can put my sword down.
Believe me, I have tried.
Outsiders think they can change us.
Freedom. What a crock.
I'd kill for some food. Again. this place a sanctum of healing and salvation. Why do you threaten it?
I'm just here to talk.
We're interested in getting into the Deep Roads. Rumor has it you were a warden. Do you know a way?
Did the warden send you to bring me back? I'm not going. Those bastards made me get rid of my cat. Poor Sir Pouncelot. He hated the Deep Roads.
You had a cat named Sir Pouncelot in the Deep Roads?
It was a gift. A noble beast. Almost got ripped in half by a Genlock once. He swatted the bugger on the nose. Drew blood, too. The blighted warden said he made me too soft. I had to give him to a friend in Amaranthine.
I've always heard that joining the Wardens is for life.
That's only partly true. The hopelessly tainted by the Darkspawn and plagued by nightmares about the Archdemon parts don't go away. But it turns out if you hide well, you don't have to wear the uniform or go to the parties.
I'm part of an expedition into the Deep Roads. Any information you have could save people's lives.
I will die a happy man if I never think about the blighted Deep Roads again. You can't imagine what I've come through to get here. I'm not interested. Although, a favor for a favor. Does that sound like a fair deal? You help me, I'll help you.
Help my expedition reach the Deep Roads, and I'll do whatever you need.
You don't ask for my terms. What if I were asking for the Knight Commander's head on a spike?
Is that what you ask?
You decide. I have a warden map of the depths in this area. But there's a price. I came to Kirkhall to aid a friend. A mage. A prisoner in the wretched gallows. The Templars learned of my plans to free him. Help me bring him safely past them, and you shall have your maps.
You've convinced me. What's your plan?
I welcome your aid. I have already sent word for Carl to meet me in the Chantry tonight. Join us there, and we'll ensure that no matter who is with him, we all walk away free.
I think this is the cellar door. Let's go. Mel. Mother described it, but this is the first time I've seen it. Wouldn't it feel like something to live in a house with this above the door?
Trap!
Point the way, Hawk.
Our family home. Did you ever think you'd be here?
I don't like the looks of this. All set!
After this, I knew I should have slit his throat.
That should do it.
That's the vault! Everything we want to know about our family is inside. This is it! Grandfather's will. Mother needs to see this as soon as possible.
We'll take it to her right now.
So I'm just saying, blood's blood and all, but you are taking advantage of my hospitality. It's only fair if you make something of a monthly contribution.
You sold my children into servitude. Now you're asking me to pay rent?
Maybe just put something towards food.
You should be paying us, Uncle. We found the will.
He forgave you, Mother. Grandfather left you everything. Here, read it.
I should... maybe...
To my daughter, Leandra, and all children born of her. The estate in Hightown and all associated revenues.
Check out the part where Gamlin is left only a stipend, to be controlled by you.
Gamlin, how could you?
You're the one who ran away, Leandra. What happened to love is so much more important than money.
It is!
You didn't even come home for the funeral!
The twins were a week old!
We all have our burdens. Mine was looking after a life you abandoned. How long was I supposed to wait?
I doubt you let the ashes get cold.
I took care of Father. I stayed. And on his deathbed, all he could talk about was Leandra. Look, sister, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have done it, but I did. And there's nothing I can do to get it back.
I don't expect that, Gamlin. It's enough to know Mother and Father didn't die angry. I'll petition the Viscount for rights to reclaim the estate. Make her willing. You'll have your house back within weeks.
You don't have the coin or standing to even get an audience with the Viscount. You've got to be someone in this city to live in that house again.
Then I had better get started.
Why don't you go pick up something at the market? You could use some air.
What? Hey!
I can't believe Gamlin stole Mother's entire inheritance. I mean, I can believe it. That's the worst part. I would never turn against you.
You're a better person than Gamlin could ever be.
Well, hopefully we'll be out of here soon. You know, when we went to look for that will, I thought we were doing it for Mother, for what she lost. I didn't realize how much it would mean to me, to know I had grandparents who didn't hate me.
I wish they had lived long enough to see us come home.
Home. That's what it is, isn't it? I like saying that. We're not running away again. We're coming home.
Are you unhappy here?
I wish I could do more for Mother. Carver's death. It's killing her slowly every day. But maybe if we can reclaim some of what she lost, it will help. I'd do anything to get us back a normal life.
We are going to make this our home, Bethany. I promise you.
I hope so, brother. I'm so very tired of running.
I found this when we were at the estate. I thought you should have it.
Is it? I think this is Mother's betrothal portrait from when she was supposed to marry the Comte. Look! You can see the ring.
I suppose it would have been a bit awkward to take it with her.
I know she loved Father. I guess I just wondered if she'd have been happier if he hadn't been a mage. If I wasn't a mage. I know that made it hard for Mother. It's nice to have a reminder of a time when she still knew how to smile.
When I told your grandmother I was marrying your father, she threatened to disown me. She said my children would be mongrels. My father wanted to lock me in, but she told him it's her life. Let her ruin it. I wrote to her when each of you were born. She never wrote back. I'm glad she didn't die hating me.
Grandmother didn't want you to leave. She tried holding on to you the only way she knew.
She would have been so proud of you. You're everything she wanted in an Amel grandchild. She might have had a hard time accepting it at first, but she would have loved you, all three of you. Carver, he was such a little boy. Never had a knee that wasn't scraped or trousers without holes.
He was so young. Never got to be the man he wanted.
I just keep thinking there's something we could have done. It's killing me. I remember that awful creature reaching down and 18 years of loving and feeding and raising and that was it.
Blame the Darkspawn, not yourself.
The Ogre would have been happy with any prey. It was my fault it was Carver. I miss him. There were four of us when the Blight began. It will never be over while there are just three. I've written to the Viscount. I have an audience for after Bartran's expedition leaves. I couldn't do anything for Carver, but with luck, I could at least give us a home. I've had word from Lothering. They are rebuilding. I don't know if I could ever return to the site of such horrors. Is this dwarven venture truly the only way? I hate to think of you going willingly into the Darkspawn's grasp. Is this dwarven venture truly the only way? I hate to think of you going willingly into the Darkspawn's grasp. He wasn't like this in Lothering. I think he misses the open fields.
Come on, let's play Fetch the Invisible Ball.
Poor thing. Maybe he'd be happier if we brought him with us more often.
He's part of the family. I wouldn't want to lose him.
Take it. I'm sick of what's-his-name staring and panting.
Gamlin, honestly, a Mabari understands what you say. Try using his name.
What's wrong with dog? Real easy to remember.
I'll let you sleep.
I hope Mother convinces the Viscount to give us the estate.
So, what? Are you here to gloat? Gamlin's the idiot again. Gamlin's the fool who can't hold his money when it's given in a bloody silver basket. I tried, you know, when Leandra left, but no one was ever going to live up to her.
What was she like, as a girl?
We're only a year apart, but that was time enough for Leandra to get our parents wrapped firmly around her little finger. They showed her off at every opportunity. The beauty, the scholar, the light of their lives. As far as they were concerned, they should have stopped there.
I've seen the nobles in this town. Your parents must have had a fortune. Where did it all go?
Well, it's not like I stood at the side of the wharf and hurled it over. I tried to invest it. Got some good tips on trade in Kunari cheeses. And, you know, A man's got needs. I'm not denying I spent more on myself than I should have, but I figured it'd all work out.
So, the best way to make Daddy love you was to steal his money?
I changed their filthy sheets and wiped their chins through two bouts of the cholera, and the last word Father said was... Leandra. I'm not looking for love, but at least I got the money.
And here I was, just about to like you.
Old Shemlin, your kind are not welcome among the Dalish.
Who are you people?
We are the last of the Elven.
Keep that in mind, Hawk. Elves you see elsewhere, figments of your imagination.
They have given up their identity to live among Shemlin. They're elven no more.
I was given an amulet for someone named Marathari.
How do you know that name?
Wait. This is the one the Keeper spoke of.
A Shemlin? I thought he'd be an elf.
Enter the camp. Keeper Marathari has been waiting for you.
Cause trouble. And you'll meet our blades, stranger.
Marathari, I was told to bring you this amulet.
Andarana Tishan, travelers. Indeed, I am Keeper Marathari. Let me look at you. There's truth in your face. A rare thing in a human. Tell me how this burden fell to you, child.
This amulet's owner rescued my family from the Blight. In return, I agreed to bring it to you.
I honor you for coming to me. But I'm afraid your part in this is not done yet. The amulet must be taken to an altar at the top of the mountain. And given a Dalish rite for the departed. Then, return the amulet to me. Do this and your debt will be repaid.
Are you going to teach me this rite for the departed?
I will send my first with you. She will see to it the ritual is done. And when it is complete, I must ask that you take her with you when you go.
Who is your first? First of what?
Your people would call her my apprentice, or heir. Meryl would have taken my place as keeper. But she has chosen a new path. Please, guide her safely from here.
If that's what you want.
It isn't what I want, but it is what she wants. You'll find Meryl waiting for you on the trail just up the mountain. Dareth Shiral.
This mountain is cursed, I swear. 3 days in a row, I'm
sure. Oh. I didn't hear. You must be the one the Keeper told me about. Anethera.
I'm so sorry. I didn't ask your name. Unless... It's not rude to ask a human their name, is it? I'm Meryl. Which you probably knew already. I'm rambling, sorry.
You'll have to work harder than that to offend me. My name's Hawk.
Thank you. I'm afraid I'm not very experienced with your kind. The Keeper said you came from Ferelden. I spent most of my life there. We only came north a few years ago. Have you been in the Free Marches long? Do you like it here?
I miss the cold and the dirt. Kirkwall's not brown enough for me. But hey, no darkspawn.
Ferelden wasn't that brown. The dirt and muck gave it character.
We should go.
Your task is for Asha Belinar. It's not wise to make her wait.
Let's get this over with. Keeper didn't mention you were a mage.
All keepers know a bit of old magic. The stories tell us that all Elven once had the gift. But like so many things, it was lost. It's a keeper's job to remember, to restore what we can.
Can't demons possess Dalish mages?
It can happen. And when it does, the clan must hunt and kill their own keeper.
Does the Chantry know about the Dalish mages?
Oh, they know. Keeper Marathari told me that was one of the reasons we never camped too long in one place. They usually won't pursue us if we stay away from the cities and towns and keep moving.
And no one minds having to pick up and move over and over just to protect a few of you.
Why would they mind? Once we've picked over a hunting ground, there's no reason to stay.
But my clan is now in more danger, having lost our Hala.
If you go to Kirkwall, you'll be an apostate in a city full of Templars.
I know. But if I don't go to Kirkwall, I'll be alone. A solitary elf is easy prey for anyone. In the city, I can get lost in the crowd.
I'm I'm glad you decided to pitch in back there.
Oh, you're welcome. I wasn't sure I'd be much good. I've done a little fighting before, but it was always alone. I'll try not to hit anyone. On our side, I mean. I'm babbling again. Let's go.
So the Keeper finally found someone to take you from here.
Yes.
Then finish your task quickly, human. We cannot be rid of this one too soon.
I'm sensing a story here.
I have made my choice. And I will save our clan whatever you think.
What's going on here, Meryl?
Nothing. Just ignorance. We should go.
Landslide blocked the path. There's a cave that should take us to the other side. I'm sorry. You're not really seeing the Dalish at their best. We're good people that look out for each other. Just not today, apparently.
But the Dalish are delightful. I was just thinking of inviting the whole clan over for tea.
I'm sure they'd never accept in a...
Oh. Right. Sarcasm. Even if my people don't appreciate my efforts, I must see this through. Let's go. Asha Belenar isn't known for her patience.
Right behind you, Hawk.
I wonder if Mother has received an audience with the Viscount yet.
I can open the way forward. One moment. I felt the veil shift. You called something here. Are you insane? Yes, it was blood magic, but I know what I'm doing. The spirit helped us, didn't it?
Sure, demons are very helpful. Right up until they take your mind and turn you into a monster.
Well, yes. But that won't happen. I know how to defend myself. Be careful up ahead. Restless things prowl the heights. In the days of Arlathan, the elders came here to sleep. Uthanara, the endless dream they called it. But they don't sleep peacefully anymore.
Amulet on the altar, and I'll begin the rite.
Amalana Sale Emma Ira Bella Zavirana Isalahamin Vinanhim Dofilas In Uthanera Narivas.
Andarana Tishan Ashabalana.
One of the people. I see. So young and bright. Do you know who I am beyond that title?
I know only a little.
Then stand. The people bend their knee too quickly. So refreshing to see someone who keeps their end of a bargain. I half expected my amulet to end up in a merchant's pocket.
I agreed to deliver the amulet, though you could have told me you were inside it.
Just a piece. A small piece. But it was all I needed. A bit of security, should the inevitable occur. And if I know my Morrigan, it already has.
Is that someone I should know?
She's a girl who thinks she knows what is what better than I or anyone. And why not? I raised her to be as she is. I cannot expect her to be less.
I'm not sure whether she's your daughter or your enemy.
Neither is she.
Why did you need me to bring you here?
Because I had an appointment to keep. And because I did not want to be followed, you smuggled me here quite nicely.
You have plans, I take it.
Destiny awaits us both, dear boy. We have much to do. Before I go, a word of advice. We stand upon the precipice of change. The world fears the inevitable plummet into the abyss. Watch for that moment, and when it comes, do not hesitate to leap. It is only when you fall that you learn whether you can fly.
Cheap advice from a dragon.
We all have our challenges.
We're going to regret bringing her here.
Regret is something I know well. Take care not to cling to it, to hold it so close that it poisons your soul. When the time comes for your regrets, remember me. As for you, child, step carefully. No path is darker than when your eyes are shut.
Maseranus Ashabelinar.
Now the time has come for me to leave. You have my thanks and my sympathy.
Maseranus, child, your debt is paid in full. It isn't too late to change your mind, Dalen.
Darath Shiral, Keeper. I'm ready. Let's depart. Elganon, is this really where the elves live?
Not the prettiest part of Kirkwall, but it doesn't have a view of the giant chains. Take what you can get.
I didn't think it would be so. I've never seen so many people in one place before. It seems so lonely.
You already know me. You'll make other friends soon enough.
Guy. Thank you. Thank you for everything. For all your help. Will you come visit me? Not now, of course. But maybe later. I could use a friend.
I'd like that, Meryl.
Thank you. Oh, I'm thanking you too much, aren't I? I mean it, though.
I am sorry for your loss, mistress.
But I can offer your son mercy only if he turns himself in.
I'm trying to find him, but...
The Templars cannot tolerate apostates.
Can we help this woman? This could be Mother.
It sounds like your son is in trouble. Is there anything I can do?
You heard all of that and still you would help? An apostate? Oh, thank you. I am Ariane. My boy, Fainriel. He's all I have. All my family. When I learned he had magic, I could not bear to send him to the Circle. But his connection to the Fade, it gives him nightmares. Dreams of demons speaking in his mind. I would rather lose him to the Circle than to himself.
Did your son run away?
He learned I had contacted Sir Thrask. He felt I betrayed his trust. He thinks he can live free of the Circle. But I am afraid without proper training, he'll kill himself.
Did your son run away?
He learned I had contacted Sir Thrask. He felt I betrayed his trust. He thinks he can live free of the Circle. But I am afraid without proper training, he'll kill himself.
Tell me the whole story.
I learned years ago that my son Lightly had magical talent, but we could not bear the thought of him locked in the gallows. So we hid. When the nightmares began, Fainriel still refused to contact the Circle. But I truly think they are the only people who might save his life.
What exactly do you need me to do?
Just find him, please. Bring him somewhere safe. I don't know where Fainriel is gone, but there are two places you might start your search. Sir Thrask has been looking for him. If you speak to him in the gallows, he'll be able to tell you what ground he's already covered. And Fainriel's father, Vincenzo, recently returned from Antiva. He's a merchant in the Lowtown Bazaar. Fainriel might have sought him out.
Tell me about this Templar.
I believe he's a good man. He doesn't hate mages, but sees what it took me too long to realize. Even the best-intentioned mages are at the mercy of their sleeping minds. There are other Templars who are much less sympathetic.
You and Fenriel's father are not married.
Vincenzo had no desire for a wife or an elf-blooded child. I haven't seen him since the day I told him. I have written, though, to keep him informed about his child. Fainriel wanted to meet him.
I will not leave you fearful for a moment longer than necessary.
Magic can be a fearful gift. Your son deserves the best aid learning how to manage it.
My husband Wesley was a Templar. They're not all fanatics to be feared.
Thank you. It has been a lonely time hiding. It's almost a relief to finally confront this openly.
You kept my brother out far too late last night.
I'm sorry I couldn't get you more information about the Circle, Bethany. It's difficult without naming you.
Thank you for being discreet. I don't want the Templars at my door.
No one does.
corral the troublemakers. I just want information.
Right. Right.
It sounds like I'm trying to convince myself, doesn't it?
I wouldn't have said, but yes.
Sarah, you look like a man who'd be interested in the finest Antivan steel to grace his hand. I bring only the best northern merchandise to the free marches.
Actually, I'm more interested in your son.
Son? I have never had that privilege, Sarah. My poor wife, she's back in Antiva and cannot see me often with my travels.
Please, Sarah. I know you must fear for Fainriel, but we mean him no harm.
Hard to tell in this city who means who harm, no?
Perhaps you can set his mind at ease.
We are no Templars, Thurah. You'll find no better friend to a young, scared mage.
Maldithion, you are a mage! I suppose you'd be kind, then, to a boy who resists being taken in by Templars?
Of course.
The boy's in over his head. So I sent him to the only man I know who doesn't despise mages. A former Templar named Samson.
Why would a Templar help him?
His conscience plagues him, having served the Templars too long. He now helps mages on the run. He stays out of sight during the day. At night, he stays near Darktown. That's the best place to find him.
old Vincenzo said someone might come sniffing around. You're looking for the boy, right? Feign something. I'll tell you now, there's not much I can do for you.
I'm looking for a retired Templar named Samson.
Retired? Sounds better than burned out husk of a Templar begging coins in the choke damp. They don't do anything to keep you, you know. You join the Order, you're free to walk away. But they're the only ones who've got the dust.
The dust?
Lyrium, an ore the dwarves mine. Magic in its raw form. You need to drink the stuff to face down the magickers. Problem is, if you ever try to stop, it just about kills you.
Is it true you give aid to apostates fleeing the Templars?
The mages are help. They're no more than children, newly discovered their magic and terrified. Barely left their mother's skirts, and now we're saying they got to be locked away for their own good. The demons are hunting them. Do you wonder they run?
Did you meet the boy?
Afraid so. Blighter was dead broke, though. Not a silver on him. I helped one mageling for free, and I'll never get paid again.
You abandoned him?
Appointed him to a ship captain I know, Rainer. Sometimes he'll take on runaways. Took another apostate last week, girl I sent him. Might have gone wrong, though. I heard rumors he took the both of them captive instead.
So your good friend's a kidnapper? Can't say I'm surprised.
Not a friend. Just someone who's not afraid to try this business. Rumor has it, Rainer had the pair of them locked inside a Keys warehouse, somewhere close to Dockside. You want to go looking? You might find the lad before he gets ransomed to the Templars. Or worse.
Ferelden in the guard. What will they think of next?
You have a problem with that?
Me? My family's not native either. I'm just surprised. Lot of old prejudice in the guard.
I'll give them plenty of reason to change their minds.
You know, it's possible they're just scared shitless of you. That's my theory, anyway.
Here you're having problems with the bone pit. I can help.
Finally someone comes to help me. You look a bit unseasoned, but I hope you'll do. I had to suspend operations. My workers are lost in the mines or have run off. Served me right for hiring Ferelden refugees. I sent others before, but no word. Perhaps they are putting me off. I need someone competent to figure out what is going on.
Your first mistake was naming your mine the Bone Pit.
The locals named the mine. Those fools say it's cursed. That is why I hire Fereldens. They may be dull-witted, but they're not superstitious.
Mind what you say about my countrymen.
I was not referring to you, of course. My workers are a particularly desperate sort. They're lucky to work for me. Few in Kirkwall will hire refugees.
Sh- Surely the miners had good reason to leave.
I am at a loss. No miner has reported in, and no one takes me seriously.
The bone pit must be dangerous if people are afraid to venture there.
No, nothing like that. Pay no heed to local superstition. The bone pit is mostly harmless.
What's the reward?
I will pay handsomely. The exact amount depends on what perils you face.
I'll head there soon.
The sooner the better. Each day the mine is not running costs me more than those miners make in a year. The bone pit is just outside the city. Any map will show it.
nothing to worry about.
Always calling and getting rid of idiots, especially thugs who target the streets just because it's dark.
Watch your step! Can't do that. Get a hold of her.
Please, help me. Anyone.
Get the hands. I heard they can't do no spells without hands.
You know nothing of magic.
If they hadn't backed that poor girl into... Do you think we can find out who she was?
These streets should be safe at night. Care to help out with that?
Bugger off!
I don't make my guards fight gangs in dark corners, but if you'd like to help...
Watch your step! All set!
Always where you need.
Not the elf. Who is that?
It doesn't matter. We were told to kill whoever enters the house.
How about you? I'll
I don't know who you are, friend, but you made a serious mistake coming here.
Lieutenant, I want everyone in the clearing, now!
Captain!
Your men are dead, and your trap has failed. I suggest running back to your master while you can.
You're going nowhere, slave!
I am not a slave. I apologize. When I asked Anso to provide a distraction for the hunters, I had no idea they'd be so numerous.
It appears we're unscathed.
Impressive. My name is Fenris. These men were Imperial bounty hunters, seeking to recover a Magister's lost property, namely myself. They were trying to lure me into the open. Crude as their methods were, I could not face them alone. Thankfully, Anso chose wisely.
Everything Anso said was a lie, then?
Not everything. Your employer was simply not who you believed.
If you couldn't fight them, why not just run?
There comes a time when you must stop running, when you turn and face the tiger.
If they were really trying to recapture you, then I'm happy I helped.
I have met few in my travels who have sought anything more than personal gain. If I may ask, what was in the chest, the one they kept in the house?
It was empty.
I suppose it was too much to hope for. Even so, I had to know.
You're expecting something else?
I was, but I shouldn't have. It was bait, nothing more.
You didn't need to lie to get my help.
That remains to be seen. It's as I thought. My former master accompanied them to the city. I know you have questions, but I must confront him before he flees. I will need your help.
It sounds like you intend to do more than just talk.
Denarius wants to strip the flesh from my bones, and has sent so many hunters that I've lost count. And before that, he kept me on a leash like a Qunari mage, a personal pet to mock Qunari custom. So, yes, I intend to do more than just talk.
If it means fighting more slavers, I'll help you.
I will find a way to repay you. I swear it. The Magister is staying at a mansion in Hightown. Meet me there as soon as you can. We must enter before morning.
Thank you.
start. The Alps are starting to get more.
Thank you.
I saw Carl go inside a few minutes ago. No Templars so far. Are you ready?
I didn't see anyone suspicious out here. Let's do this fast.
All right. I'll handle the talking. You watch for Templars. When we find Carl, just let me talk to him.
Anders, I know you too well. I knew you would never give up.
What's wrong? Why are you talking like...
I was too rebellious, like you. The Templars knew I had to be... made an example of.
No!
How else will mages ever master themselves? You'll understand, Anders. As soon as the Templars teach you to control yourself. This is the apostate.
Take another mage as you took him!
Ah!
I... Andis, what did you do? It's like... you brought a piece of the Fade into this world. I had already forgotten what that feels like.
I thought the Tranquil were cut off from the Fade forever.
When you're Tranquil, you never think on your life before. But... it's like the Fade itself is inside, Andis. Burning like a sun. Please, kill me before I forget again. I don't know how you brought it back, but it's fading.
Carl, no!
Maybe we can find a cure.
Can you cure a beheading? The dreams of Tranquil mages are severed. There is nothing left of them to fix.
I would rather die a mage than live as a Templar puppet.
The Tranquil I've met seem content with their lot. Maybe it's not that bad.
You have no idea. Your emotions, your dreams, everything stripped away on someone's whim. If I were made Tranquil, I would wish for a friend compassionate enough to kill me. Carl, I'm sorry.
Now! It's fading! Why do you look at me like that?
Goodbye. We should leave before more Templars come.
That wasn't normal magic you just did, was it?
This is hard to explain. When I was in Amaranthine, I met a spirit of justice who was trapped outside the Fade. We became friends, and he recognized the injustice that mages in Thedas face every day.
And that's different than a demon?
Just as demons prey on the deadly sins of mankind, there are good spirits who embody our virtues. Spirits of compassion, fortitude, justice. They are the Maker's first children, and they have all but given up on us.
This spirit sounds like a useful friend to have.
He was far better to me than I have been to him. To live outside the Fade, he needed a host. I offered to help him. We were going to work together, bring justice to every child ever ripped away from his mother to be sent to the Circle. But I guess I had too much anger. Once he was inside me, he changed.
This is obviously difficult for you.
I thought I was helping my friend. He would have died, I guess. If that even means anything. And he wanted to help me. He knew what mages have suffered.
You tried to help a friend. Surely no harm can come of that.
I wish I still had your innocence. There was too much hatred in me. Justice thought he would overcome that. But my anger, when I see Templars now, things that have always outraged me, but I could never do anything about, he comes out. And he is no longer my friend, Justice. He is a force of vengeance, and he has no grasp of mercy.
Is there anything I can do for you?
You're the first one I've ever told this. Thank you for not running away. My maps are yours. As am I, if you wish me to join your expedition. I thought I was done with the Grey Wardens. But if you have any need of me, I will be waiting here. I had a friend like you once. Got in all kinds of trouble. Dragged me along. Didn't think I'd be doing that again. I got a bit weighty the last time we talked. Sorry for putting that on you.
You can tell me anything.
Anything? Be careful what you offer. I just...
I hope I didn't seem too selfish when I told you about justice. I didn't know what would happen. I figured a willing host, a friend. It had to be better than playing the demon and haunting some corpse.
We can't always predict the outcome of our actions. We can only make them with a true heart.
Well, under that scruffy exterior, I think you've got a bit of a soft heart yourself. I'm sorry, I shouldn't presume. We've hardly met and I feel like I know you. Am I making you uncomfortable?
Am I making you uncomfortable?
Growing up in the Circle, everything is about order and rules and the Templars. The apprentices, we found ways to make that bearable. Carl and I, he was the first. We could forget that out in the world, we were nothing but Templar slaves. We hadn't been together for a long time. But still, it hurt.
No one should have to go through that.
It's the bloody Templars. They don't see us as people. They don't care that Carl was someone's son, someone's lover. If you're born with magic, they hear about it. They search your little rat-spit village and find you. They tell your parents they'll be thrown in prison if they ever ask about you, stripped of their rights in the eyes of the Maker. And if you run away, they hunt you down, again and again and again.
You're speaking from personal experience.
Andraste's words were that magic must not rule over man. It is not ruling to simply wish for the same rights as any man. But I shouldn't say that too loudly. I don't want you hurt just for knowing me. I appreciate your help and support.
We shouldn't talk here.
No one has left the mansion, but I've heard nothing within. Daenerys may know we're here. I wouldn't put it past him.
I could stand to know a little more about this Daenerys.
He is a magister of the Tevinter Imperium.
Oh, is that all? Nothing to worry about, then.
There, he is a wealthy mage with great influence. Here, he is but a man who sweats like any other when death comes for him.
He may have prepared some magical defenses.
They will not keep me from him.
Thank you.
Denarius, show yourself.
Trap! That should do it.
Sends spirits to do his fighting for him.
Denarius! Can you hear me? Your pets cannot stop us!
I don't think I can do that.
Match.
gun. I had hoped... No, it doesn't matter any longer. I assume Denarius left valuables behind. Take them if you wish. I need some air. It never ends. I escaped a land of dark magic, only to have it hunt me at every turn. It is a plague burned into my flesh and my soul. And now I find myself in the company of even more mages.
You can speak to me directly.
I saw you casting spells inside. I should have realized sooner what you really were. You harbor a viper in your midst. It will turn on you and strike when you least expect. That is in its nature.
My sister is stronger than you think.
You tell him, brother.
I'm not blind. I know magic has its uses, and there are undoubtedly mages with good intentions. But even the best-intentioned mage can fall prey to temptation. And then their power is a curse to inflict upon others.
No one's stopping you from moving on, you know.
I imagine I appear ungrateful. If so, I apologize, for nothing could be further from the truth. I did not find Denarius, but I still owe you a debt. Here is all the coin I have, as Anso promised. Should you find yourself in need of assistance, I would gladly render it.
Are you going to have a problem with my companions?
I will watch them carefully if we travel together. I can promise no more.
Your old master must want something more than just a runaway slave.
He doesn't want me at all, just the markings on my skin. They are lyrium, burned into my flesh to provide the power that Denarius required of his pet. And now, he wishes his precious investment returned, even if he must rip it from my corpse.
Perhaps you can find a way to pay him back.
I will pay him back. In blood. You have no idea what he's done to me, what I went through just to get away.
I was only trying to help you.
That was unworthy of me. The truth is, I know nothing of the ritual that placed these markings on me. It was Denarius's choice, one he now regrets.
I'm planning an expedition I might need help with.
Fair enough. Should you ever have need of me, I will be here. If Denarius wishes his mansion back, he is free to return and claim it. Beyond that, I am at your disposal.
howl in the dark.
Ha!
Why, look here, boys. Volunteers. Clap them in irons and let's see what the Tevinters will pay for them.
I'd make a terrible slave. I talk too much. And I do that.
Nobody threatens me on my ground. Shut this buck up.
He shipped Fainreal. Looks like they took him to some bolt hole in the Wounded Coast. The danger is past. Are you all right?
No thanks to this lot. Can't get a decent blade at a bargain anymore. You, though, you're what a man needs. A skilled enthusiast.
You can start making sense any time now.
My manners. Javaris Tintop, merchant and investor. I need forward thinkers to help court the Kunari.
Court the Kunari? Make her think of the children.
Those hornheads in Kirgwall have a powder that explodes, and it's just dust. No lyrium, no demons. Anyone can use it.
I often look at every second idiot and think, he needs more power.
I doubt they were eager to sell.
That Arashok said I wasn't worthy. Not only their outcast, the Tal Vashath, or that mercenary. I said, great, I'll go talk to them. Didn't go over well. But made me think. Maybe he'll bargain if I get rid of something that bothers him more than, well, me.
The Tal Vashath.
The Tal Vashath. Are you up for some paid hunting?
People must have something like that already.
Small things, shaped to crack faults, not shatter the earth. Plus, they're mostly lyrium. Expensive, poisonous, the Chantry controls it topside, the glow makes you a target. Problem after problem.
I suppose there could be a reward for these Tal Vashath.
As long as you do it, I'm happy. Now, best I could figure, they're up the Wounded Coast, a whole camp. Take their heads off and meet me at the compound in Kirkwall. Get this right, and we'll be richly rewarded. Richly.
So, what do you do, Aveline?
You know I'm a guard. Why are you asking?
I mean in your off-duty hours, for fun. You've heard of it, I hope.
These are my off-duty hours.
I'm not a werewolf. How many times do I have to say it? You're crazy.
Lies!
Help! This crazy elf is going to kill me!
He doesn't look like a werewolf, Dalish. He seems harmless.
He hides in human form. Do not let him fool you.
Please. She's scaring me.
Is this what your mother would want?
But he murdered her.
This man may have a wife, children, certainly a family. What will they think of you? Kill him, and you become him.
You shame me. My mother would not want this. Leave Shem, before I change my mind.
We shouldn't talk here.
Let's make this quick!
We shouldn't talk here.
All set.
Take one more step, and the boy dies.
Tell this dirtbag who we are.
If I were you, I wouldn't be threatening the Viscount's son.
What?
Oh, I suppose you just got a tip from a slaver that he was selling mage flesh cheap. You never thought to ask where he got it? You never wondered if you were buying the Viscount's well-known love child from his elven mistress? The boy he swore to protect, even if it meant raising the entire Free Marches?
I seek no war with the Free Marches. Take the lad to his father.
Oh? That's quite a generous offer.
This was the price set on the boy. Please accept it as an offer of peace.
Who are you? Are you working for the Templars?
Your mother sent me.
Huh. Hardly a difference. I can't believe her. My whole life it was all, I'll love you and protect you. Then I have some bad dreams and it's off to the Templars.
I'm here to help you, Fenriel.
Why? You don't even know me.
I've spent my whole life protecting my sister from exactly what you fear.
Is there any chance you'd help me reach the Dalish? That's where I was trying to go. See if they'd take me in. I'm as much Dalish as human.
Even more than a Dalish would be here.
Compared to being held prisoner, or made tranquil. I'll risk being lonely. Look, I know it's different in other kingdoms, but here, no one helps Circle mages. Anything the Templars don't like, you get the brand. The Dalish. They've had magic forever. They could teach me. I won't be a danger, I swear.
If there is another place he can harness his gifts, I cannot blame him for wishing to go there.
If there was another way, the Circle would know it.
You deserve a chance at freedom.
Thank you. I did not. In my wildest dreams, I could not have foreseen this. Thank the creators, you were the one my mother hired to find me. I will forever be in your debt, friend.
Whatever their differences, his mother deserves to know he's alive.
So, a Lady Sunshine, what's your first act as a noblewoman going to be?
A noblewoman with no fortune and no title. Looking for work, probably.
Practicality is for peasants, m'lady. You need to do something frivolous to celebrate your birthright.
Such as?
Come up to the Hightown Market and complain bitterly that there's no Orlesian silk that matches your eyes.
But what if something does match my eye? What will I do then?
Insist that they're blatantly copying you and demand royalties. A good noble always has a complaint ready, Sunshine. Water. Pretty exciting, I know.
That should do it.
Shove off, you.
Your son has taken refuge with the Dalish.
What? But he is human. They did not even wish me to raise him among them. But they do value magic more than the men of Kirkwall. Perhaps he can have both safety and freedom. As I said, I have little money, but this is a Dalish ring that has been in my family for generations. Please accept it with my thanks.
Greetings. What more does she want from us? Busy today, I see.
Well, why
life is over, her sickness of hope. The worst is over. I pray she'll get better soon. I've missed too much work already.